Okay, we have a new project. I have ordered a 40-foot container. And I gotta get this spot ready for it. I'm gonna take this edge here and remove that, everything to the side. So let's get started.
Thank you.
getting to the end of the day here. Get that area leveled off and get that dirt out of there. And then I gotta go level off the piles that I've dumped there. This is a 1972 Chevrolet C50. So, 2.5 ton. Put new brakes, hydro boost. It's a 4-speed with a 2-speed rear end, 2-speed axle. Works well. It's got a 350 V8 small block, camel back heads, 2-barrel carb. New tires and rims. I got rid of the split rims and found some one-piece 22.5-inch wheels and all new rubber all the way around. Put some electrical into it all the way to the back for an electric brake controller for my trailer. Been dinging up the box to make sure that the dirt stays in the box when I want it to and not going all over the road. DOT would frown upon that. PTO on the dump box. Brake is on neutral, PTO engaged, dump box, and
tailgate release.
Take a look, see if I can just dress it up without hauling anything more, and then I can knock those piles down. All right, other than some packing, this looks pretty good. I think I got that backside built up. I want to knock those piles down because I gotta get to those. That area in the front of the house. Got a walkout basement. All right, I'm gonna drive. I'm not gonna record this here, because I don't have a place to put this phone. I don't have any fancy stuff here, and I need two hands to drive this thing. Okay, here's the site.
Thank you.
We're gonna have a deck here someday coming off of that rim joist there. So I wanna make a little bit more frontage. That deck will come out about 10 feet, 12 feet, something like that. So I just wanted a little bit more. Probably gonna lose that tree. You know what? Make more. I lose some of these trees in here, but I like to have some frontage off the deck edge here, so I'm not too afraid of losing these trees. I got lots of them around, so. And made a little bank here so I can get down the hill. I'll fill that in a little bit more as we go. I'll just keep filling in as I get dirt out of the other side of the property. Back at it. I laid the railroad ties down. The white paint is 40 foot mark to the back of that railroad tie. Getting a ballpark and seeing where I'm at for level in that. Now I'm gonna say that that's not too bad. I take out a little bit from the right side. Get really persnickety, but I'm close. Now I don't have a laser level yet. Someday I'll get one. So I just got four nails, put this in the corner of the railroad tie. I'm using the top of the railroad tie as a plane. The opposite corner there. Okay, I guess it's better to be lucky than good. This is the highway side of the container, end for end. Again, I just eyeballed this with the skid steer and excavator and packed it down with the C50. So, all right, I'll do the hypotenuse now. Okay, this is the opposite. Looks pretty good to me. Again, I'll have to move that tie when they come deliver it as they back that trailer in. Straighten it out. There you go, straight back. Just I'm gonna take one look, hold on. Come on back. You may have to go, there you go. A little bit more to the right. Eight, six, four. Take a look for parallel, how much is it? I kind of want to see how parallel we are. I hate to jockey around too much, but sure. Since we got you hooked up. Yeah, I'll look at the light. Yeah, take a look.
It's a little tough to adjust.
Yeah, I mean, yeah,
small,
yeah.
You know, because it's so long, I got to
right.
Stay moving along the shot for it. But.
So, I want, yeah, I'm just trying to get this corner right here and then parallel with the clearing there. Yeah, yeah. Right there. Well, it looks pretty good there. Let's see if it stays, huh? There it goes. That side's staying, this one isn't. Yeah. Sorry. I got up at that bank pretty good.
Well, here it is. Feeling pretty happy that we got the container in its general location. I'm happy with the shape that it's in. It's a one-way use container, 40 foot long, 9.5 feet high, single-sided doors. And I do have to adjust these railroad ties. As you saw in the video, they slid forward on the back, so should be pretty easy to lift up that container with the equipment I have, and we'll get that lined up better. I was told that you can, if you at least get the railroad tie butted up against this corner here, it should be fine. See, there's an actual plate here that's reinforcing that. But oftentimes, that will suffice as well. So I'll do that front and back. So I'll just drag this forward, hooking into here, and if I need for lifting it up manually, I'll just use a farm jack, or I can do it that way too, especially on the back side where I can't get a piece of equipment if I need to lift that corner up. But I'll drag it forward a little bit. We'll see. Pretty happy. Got quite a few vents. So that's cool. And did I say that it matched the garage pretty well? I'm liking that. Here comes Finley. Hi, Finley. How you doing, buddy? Hi, friend. All right. Oh, bless you. How you doing, happy boy? Oh yeah, let's give you a scratch there, huh? Oh yeah. All right. Well, you ready to go for a little ride, huh? You ready to go? You ready? We gotta go for a little ride? Okay. All right. Okay. So if you liked what you've seen, feel free to subscribe if you wish. Give a like and all of that. And maybe I'll do an update when I get this container measured up. I'm going to put a little gravel in here and
make a little ramp to haul things and get stuff in there. So I'm just gonna put gravel up in there. All right, have a great day, guys. Thanks for watching.